In this tutorial, I'm going to demonstrate how to transfer and share data using a method called Globus. We recommend Globus for data transfer because it's easy to use, it's powerful, and it's secure. On our webpage, we have a page about Globus, and you can get to it by going to hpc.nih.gov, then click on How To and Transfer Files. And that brings you to our file transfer page. Near the top, you see the section called Data Transfer and Sharing Using Globus. If I click on that link, that brings me to our Globus transfer page. And that has lots of information, including logging into Globus with your NIH login, how to install the Globus client on a Windows, Mac, or Linux system, and transferring data between your desktop and Biowulf. So this is the go-to page for any information about using Globus at NIH. So let me demo how I would use Globus to transfer data. I start by going to globus.org and I click on the login link. And that brings me to a page which offers the option of using your existing organizational login. So I can pull down the drop-down menu and find NIH, or I can simply start typing National Institutes of Health, and I click on Continue. And that brings me to a familiar looking page, the NIH login page. Once I log in with my NIH login username and password, I get to this page. And it has two windows, one for a source and one for a destination endpoint. The Helix and Biowulf Globus endpoint is called NIH HPC Data Transfer. So that's what I'm going to enter as one of the endpoints. And because I use Globus a lot, it remembers my favorite endpoints. So I can just select that one and go to NIH HPC Data Transfer. And it logs me into my home directory on Helix and Biowulf. And my other endpoint is going to be my laptop, where I have Globus Connect Personal installed. So I can now select a file from one endpoint, say this one, and click on the button to transfer it to the other endpoint. You see a message comes up saying transfer request submitted successfully. At this point, Globus will monitor and manage the transfer until it's complete. So that message went away, it's complete now. If I now click on refresh list, I should see that file on my laptop, because I just transferred it using Globus. Simple enough. If you scroll down to the bottom of the page, you see some transfer options. One is sync, only transfer new or changed files. Verify file integrity after transfer, or encrypt the transfer so that the entire the file is encrypted during the transfer as well. And these may be options that you want to use. Beyond file transfer, Globus has other very powerful options such as file sharing. Many NIH researchers are engaged in collaborative projects with other people in the institute, in other parts of NIH, or at other institutions, and they need to share data between the groups. It's not always easy or obvious how to share data securely, especially for large amounts of data. So if I go back to the hpc.nih webpage, under How To, there's an option for Share Data. And that brings you to our Sharing Data page, which offers suggestions for how to share data with NIH collaborators who have Helix or Biowulf accounts, who don't have Helix or Biowulf accounts, or any collaborators. And one of the options listed on this page is Globus. If you want to share data with other people, we highly recommend that you go to this webpage, read through the possible situations, and select the option that's most suitable for you and your situation. And if you can't figure out how best to share data, send us email at staff@hpc.nih.gov, and we can try and give you some advice. So going back to our Globus webpage, how would we share data during Globus? That's what I'm going to demonstrate now. Globus allows you to share a directory, but not individual files. Suppose I decide that I want to share this directory, csds_data. Then I can select the directory and click on this share button. And that brings me to a web page where I can name the share. I can call it csddata. And I can give it a description. And click on create. At this point, it's created a new shared endpoint that contains only that directory. And at this point, I'm the only person who can access it. But of course, the whole point of this was to share data with some other people. So I can enter a username or a Globus username or a Globus group or an email address. So if I want to share data with joe@schmoe.org, I click on the add button. You see a line called permissions here. By default, Joe would have read permissions, but not write permissions. And I can select read or read and write. But let's leave it at read for now. I click on add here. And it's going to send Joe an email at the address that I entered. And I can add some kind of message like this is csddata. And add permission. If I scroll up, you see that Joe now has read permission to the data. And Joe will have got an email with a link in it that he can use to download the data. At any point, I have complete control over this shared endpoint. I can turn off Joe's access by clicking on this red X. Are you sure you want to revoke access? I say revoke access, and Joe now no longer has access to this endpoint. I can also delete the endpoint completely by clicking on endpoint list, administered by me, and you see the CSD data endpoint that I just created. And I can delete the endpoint. If Joe downloaded data from that endpoint, he would have had access only to that directory that I shared specifically with him, and no other access to any other directories on Helix or Biowulf. So that was an example of sharing data using Globus. And for more information on Globus, go to our webpage about Globus. And the URL will show up right after this. Thank you.